What's up, you guys? Welcome to episode 3 of the BRZ Drift Build. This is not the BRZ, but this is my brother's car. Not his first rodeo, just saying. Adrian!
Yeah?
Come here! Tell us something about your whip.
It's attracted to crowds.
It's attracted to crowds.
It just can't help itself.
Has it? Oh, look, and he's got this shirt.
I did wear the shirt.
Well, this is his Mustang GT. What have you done to it? Come here. They can't see you there. Here, wait. Have a seat.
Come.
Is this an interview?
This is an interview, okay. And you are getting massage.
Work have you done to this?
What work? I have,
Okay, don't sit down. Please look out.
I've put louvers on the car. As you can see, the louvers, and I have added the rear non-seats.
What he means is he deleted the back seats. He put a cover on it. So let's check it out.
Let's close this because they don't want to see what you got in the trunk. You have too much junk in the trunk.
Look on the side. You can see if you look in the back seat. I got no back seat here.
Back seat delete. Why did you do this?
I didn't want back seats.
And the main reason these guys crash is because they put these things in the rear and you can't see the crowds. It kind of makes it a little... gives it a cozy vibe in here. Adrian, tell us here, what wheels do you have and what do you have done here to this thing?
Okay. Like,
what are these?
We got the GT500 style wheels right here. Perfect in the front. Nothing going on here. There's absolutely nothing has happened to the car.
It's a perfect clean title, huh?
Perfect.
Hasn't been wrecked into crowds yet?
Not at all. Not yet.
Insert wrecked car here.
You got the emblems,
GT, you gotta have the GT emblems.
Got the emblems, and that's about it.
What we're going to attempt to do is fasten these into this back seat somehow so that they are not loose like so.
There you go. Now what do you have to say for yourself?
It's good.
Very good. What's up, you guys? It's Sam from the future. Hopefully, if you're watching this, previous footage that I took of everything else I did pulled through. Too much quality in the newest video or this one. Hopefully, everything pulled through. If it did, I'm glad. And if it didn't, then let me show you guys the progress we have.
What we have done is pulled out the back seats, took out the fuel pump with everything. This stuff here is some seriously sticky stuff.
I told myself I wouldn't rip out the interior until it was completely necessary, but it is now completely necessary. So where we are now, we're working on the fuel pump. All right, you guys, we have done properly. So if you can, please solder things. Okay, you guys, so we are in a situation. Basically, what's gonna end up happening is I'm gonna put a fuel cell in the back, a racing fuel cell, but meanwhile, till everything comes in, because I wanna get to the point where we get this thing running finally, this fuel tank is gonna come down. We're gonna put a fuel cell in the back, and we're gonna use a Dishworks for the fuel cell in the rear, and that is the game plan. We're gonna throw this in just so we can get it over with, and then I'll show you guys the wiring for the switch panel.
Just throwing this in there and wiring it up, and temporarily until we can get a fuel cell somewhere in the back here. After searching, I figured out that this pops out of here, and all I have to do is make a little cutout here, just make this a little bit wider on each side. Okay, so what you want is for this to be very snug. As you can see, it barely even fits in there because you want this excess to be able to bolt down. So you don't want to go all the way to the outside. Here we guys go. So flush, nice and even from this little line. We don't want it to look tacky or crooked. And this is what the back looks like. So as you can see, barely gave it enough room so that this inside part comes in, and then you still want to bolt these through. I'm probably going to get a little cutoff wheel and just cut these out so that there is no accidental rubbing on these tips and causes a shortage. We cut off the power. This is the power going to the actual fuse box. So this fuse box is gone. And then this ground, we actually cut it by accident. We should have just left this ground, kept it going. But I cut it, so since I cut it, I gotta put it back on. I could have grounded it out to the chassis or something, but I just thought I'd leave it be since this is gonna be a temporary fix. Anyway, so we got that done. And essentially, the only one that matters here is this green wire from the fuel pump, because this is the one giving it the power. And the ground is coming off of the actual fuse box, or off of the the fuse box. So this green wire I ran under here all the way through the bottom, all the way around in and to the dash panel. The panel here, as you can see, is just a positive and a negative, and I ran it. This is not a permanent fix, this is temporary. So I ran these two lines from the battery directly. Now you can kind of see it there, but that gave us the power. You can hear it. And you can see it. Now I'm going to clean up the wiring, bring it across through the firewall so that it's not looking like that, and put some proper terminals on it so that there's no safety hazard in a sense, or fire hazard, and it's done properly, because you don't want it to catch on fire in the middle of the track or something on a bump. And those lines that are bare, I have a plastic hose that I'm gonna put around it. Essentially, I'm gonna put on some of this hose. Just open it up, bring it all the way through, and then just tape occasionally. Okay guys, so we just realized a couple things. One, the LS3 is a returnless fuel system. Because it is a returnless fuel system, what I need is a fuel pressure regulator. So the engine is here, the fuel pump is here. In between, there's a regulator, basically determine that only a certain amount of pressure goes that way and the rest will go into the line back. Also, a little update on the drive shaft. The drive shaft for the car, there is a shop locally, and I called them about it, and they basically said it's no sweat, that it's easiest thing ever. So I'm assuming that to go very smooth. I feel like I get done a lot and then I watch everything and I realize that I did nothing. I guess that's the point of building cars, you know, little baby steps. But the important thing is for them to get done right. I ordered an angle kit, and the wide body kit is somewhere lost. According to them, it's still being made, so hopefully the quality's there with it too, since it's also taking a minute. And we also figured out the color that the BRZ is going to be after the wide body kit is installed. Take your guess. You can probably guess the color. Think of the mood in here, and that will give you an idea of what the color will be. Thank you guys for watching. Again, stay tuned for episode 4. Y'all have a good one, and we'll see y'all in the next episode.